Hello from Chem Help ASAP. The simplest functional groups are chains of carbon atoms. These are broadly called alkyl groups. There are specific names for each alkyl group based on the number of carbons in the chain. Alkyl groups are closely associated with the idea of R groups. R groups are a way to introduce a wild card or variable group into a molecule. We have a small table on the left-hand side of the screen. It lists alkyl groups. If you have one carbon in a chain, it is called a methyl group. It can be abbreviated with an ME. The condensed structural format equivalent is CH3. As we add carbons to make the chain longer, we get ethyl, or ET, propyl, PR, and butyl, BU groups. We can go longer, but chains longer than butyl groups are uncommon in drug-like molecules. Let's look at ethanol. We could write ethanol with a CH3 on the end. We could write ethanol with a CH3CH2 on the end. We could write ethanol with an ET for ethyl on the end. The next molecule is phenylbutazone, a veterinary anti-inflammatory drug that is also called bute. Phenylbutazone contains a four-carbon chain. This is a butyl group. We could redraw the structure with the BU abbreviation instead. R groups are different. R groups are variable labels used in molecules in place of other groups. For example, we can go back to ethanol. Redraw ethanol as ROH, and then define R as being equal to ET. We could also draw ROH, and now define R to be equal to several R groups, such as methyl, ethyl, and propyl. With one picture, we've now drawn three different molecules because the R group can be replaced with either three different alkyl groups. A single molecule can have multiple R groups. One might be labeled simply R. The next might be R prime. And the next might be R double prime. This method uses one structure to show similar molecules that vary in structure at one, two, or three positions.